Very good evening, hello and welcome. You are watching News Night on Times Now World. My name is Pranesh Kumar Roy. Thanks for joining me here. The big story we are tracking is from the JNU, and our hashtag is JNU India Parade. The reason why we have called it JNU India Parade is because of these visuals. The NCC cadets all set to march inside the JNU campus on Republic Day. This has taken viewers almost 50 years. The opposition was quick to politicize this. The left mocked the RSS by saying that the march should have been taken to the RSS headquarters. There are many who say this is negative campaign. Before I open this up, let's listen into reactions coming in.
As far as NCC is concerned, it teaches our students many things. It teaches leadership. It teaches how to work in a team. It emphasizes on physical fitness. So there are many positive things that a student can get by being part of the NCC. And there's a huge interest among our students to join in NCC. We have close to about 25 cadets in our unit. We are all very happy that on 26th January, they will be conducting a parade during the flag hoisting ceremony. Okay. So we are all very happy about it. We are very happy to tell you that a large number of students participate in these events.
Mm-hmm. Revamp of JNU brand, is it what you're looking for?
As of today, nearly 88% of the students, they have cleared their hostel dues. Mm-hmm. They are back in the classrooms and research labs. And that is what we want our students to do, study and do research and contribute to the country.
You know, there was a time when there used to be no such celebration for Republic Day in our campuses. Instead, we used to have celebration of Afzal Guru Shahada Divas and celebrations when our Indian Army soldiers used to get martyred in Naxal areas. But times are changing now.
But JNU ke logo ko badnaam kiya ja raha hai, because I believe that JNU is used as a camouflage to hide the real crisis of the nation, that is economic crisis, and the recent Devinder Singh Afzal Guru.
You heard the reactions from the JNU Vice Chancellor and the students from both the ABVP and the NSUI. Now sample the political reactions.
First of all, BJP should march to RSS headquarters in New Delhi and see whether national flag is hoisted there. BJP should march to RSS headquarters in Nagpur and ensure that national flag is hoisted. Why they are questioning ordinary citizens? What BJP? BJP has no role in fighting for our independence. Earlier it was Jansang, then it became BJP. And what is their history? Did they fight for the Indian independence? They should not ask parties like me. And our party was in the forefront of the freedom movement. We made supreme sacrifices. We don't need any certificate from any BJP or RSS.
Well, the NCC cadets, and the girls in particular, is a standing example of the national connect and the national unity. While Rahul Gandhi was asked once about NCC and he didn't know anything about it. But this is a standing example that students in JNU are connected with the national mainstream and stand for the integrity of the nation.
Let me quickly open this up. Joining us, Shazia Ilmi, spokesperson of the Bhartiya Janata Party. Syed Asad Abbas is a political analyst, and Professor Vishweshwar Rao from Osmania University completes the panel. Good evening to all of you. Syed Asad Abbas, let me begin with you. What is the problem with this?
Pranesh Roy Sahab, I absolutely have no problem with the National Cadet Corps. When I was a school captain of Cathedral High School, I was a head boy, and the NCC used to be a part of it. I have huge respect for them. But the problem here is the Jawaharlal Nehru University was established in the year 1969. From the year 1969 to say 2019 or 2020, for so many years now, we never had any Republic Day March parade. How does it come? When BJP leaders such as Subramanian Swamiji says, the JNU has become a hub of anti-nationals and we need to flush out by giving them a dose of patriotism. So this pseudo sense of patriotism, which they want to bring in into JNU and do this is more of a drama which is being set out. If they really want to sense patriotism. RSS does not hoist the Indian national tiranga. I think first they should set a precedent in the RSS headquarters at Nagpur.
Mr. Abbas,
they should,
I think you're mistaken. NCC, this is the NCC we are talking about, not the RSS. Let's talk on facts. This is not the ABVP or the RSS contingent
to,
marking.
RSS
this is the NCC contingent. 1 minute. And just because it has not happened over the last 50 years, no, 1 minute. Just because it has not happened over so many years does not mean it can't happen now. And what is wrong in patriotism?
Why now is the question, sir? Pranay Sahab, the real question is why do they want to do it now? Why not earlier? That is the real question.
Professor Rao?
The BJP spokesperson could answer, please.
No, no, I'll get Shazia to respond. But Professor Rao, your opening comment, sir. What do you make of this?
They should not be talking about, you know, they should not be talking about, you know, NCC cadet parade. They should be talking about academic values. They should be talking about, you know, academic freedom there. They should be talking about giving autonomy for, you know, the university and professors there. And we are also interested in knowing what happened to the attack there. No one has been arrested there. The Vice Chancellor has a responsibility in terms of answering this, rather than, you know, talking about, you know, pseudo-patriotism of 10 students or 15 students taking a parade. And what is important, universities are supposed to be doing research. Universities are supposed to be debating and discussing. At a point of time when he is stifling the university functioning, when he does not allow, you know, students to protest or students to debate, you know, what is the pseudo-patriotism he is talking about, you know, by allowing? They did not allow it for 50 years. You know, now, you know, the context, you know,
so
we are
I don't understand. How is this pseudo-patriotism? Okay, let me
that
get Shazia in. Shazia,
you know,
is this pseudo-patriotism?
You know, showing it to the country that they are patriotic. That's absolutely pseudo-patriotism. False patriotism.
So, if these gentlemen have vented, can I come in?
Please.
Yeah.
Okay, so first of all, I'd like to say that for these two gentlemen, this is drama. This is pseudo-patriotism. What is for them good ethical behavior and good protocol for a university is to have some of his students vandalize the server room to prevent the registration of new students, to create sheer anarchy, to allow for Umar Khalids of the world and Shaila Rashes and Kanhaiya Kumar to support and actually give naras saying Afzal hum sharminda hain, tere qatil zinda hain. It's all right for them to endorse freedom of speech camouflaged as anti-national and seditious sloganeering which says Bharat ki barbadi tak jang chalegi and so on and so forth. They will fight for the rights of those students who want to shut down the university, no, do not allow exams, and who dictate terms about who should be the vice chancellor and whether exams should be conducted or not. But they have a problem with NCC cadets, young, bright students who don uniform. Let me finish again. You heckling.
Professor Rao,
don't be intolerant.
I'll give you time, sir. She didn't interrupt while you were talking. Professor Rao, I'll come back to you. You can respond to what she's saying.
Yes, sir. Learn some manners. Professor, you're a professor. You should lead by example. You should not heckle and you should not be so intolerant with someone else's opinion. You talked about the university's right to debate. You should allow for a free and fair debate, even allow those who disagree with you and who expose you, which is exactly what I'm doing, Professor. And also, I'd like to make another point.
Yeah.
No. There is no matter. Everybody knows, and Aishi Ghosh and others, what they were doing. We all know how registration was prevented.
Let's not get into the details of the probe. That's for the police.
So he's okay with that.
No, okay. Let's talk on the issue at hand.
Okay. Yeah. On NCC. Let me come back to NCC. Let's come back on NCC.
Yeah.
I remember it was the proudest moment of my life. I was the head girl of St. Mary's Convent, Kanpur. And on flag hoisting day, both on 15 August and 26 January, I would lead the school march holding the flag high and be there. It was one of the happiest days of my life and many students' lives. I don't think that was pseudo-patriotism anyway. So I don't know what you're talking about. I do not respect the sentiment you express against the sentiment of patriotism. I do not get that. And more importantly, my last point. My last point is the question is not why now, but why not earlier? Not my question is not why now, but why not earlier is my answer to your question.
I think Syed Asad Abbas wants to respond to you. Go ahead, Mr. Abbas.
Okay. Yes, a quick counter. Well, without the Supreme Court's verdict or without anything, it's very easy for BJP spokesperson such as Shazia Ilmi or even Subramanian Swamiji to call the students of JNU as anti-nationals or the Tukde gang. When Sakit Gokhaleji recently did an RTI check on Tukde gang, there is absolutely no mention or presence of it. So this shows this is basically a figment of imagination of Amit Shahji and the BJP people. Secondly, Kanhaiya Kumar, Umar Khalid, Shehla Rashid, to the core, are absolute patriots. It's wrong to put Lanchan. At the outset, Afzal Guru Murdabad, let me tell you, and those who want divisive India, who want to do, jo baatna chahte hain Hindustan ko tukde-tukde mein, unko bhi Murdabad. Secondly, very conveniently, Shazia Ilmi ji has still not given a satisfactory answer as to, in the last so many years from 1969 till 2019, you never had a Republic Day March parade.
No, no, she now, wants you to answer that Jane question. She says, why not? Why has it taken so long?
I answered, I said, why earlier?
She's saying, why has it taken so long?
My question is to
also,
your question.
Now I have a, just 10 seconds, 10 seconds, ma'am. Ma'am, I have a question.
It should have happened much earlier.
Then you answer.
I think it's very late.
Okay, RSS. RSS.
No, no, answer that. Answer that. Why so late? Why not earlier?
Just 10 seconds, ma'am, please. RSS in Nagpur, when will BJP or the RSS hoist the national flag at RSS? Ma'am, could you please answer?
No, you want to talk about RSS of Nagpur? I will start talking about Shiv Sena and Sonia Sena. And I will start talking about the corruption and I will start talking about nepotism and dynastic rule. So let's stick to the topic.
But RSS
you're obviously
yours,
uncomfortable.
BJP is
because
yours.
You know, I've answered a
RSS
question with my question.
BJP equals
so
BJP.
That's why you're running away.
Equals
you're running
Mr.
away.
Abbas,
I'm very happy that there is
but
an NCC parade
question,
at the Republic Day. And I think it should have happened earlier. It's a matter of shame that it's not happened earlier.
Professor Rao, should it have
now.
Happened earlier?
I think we all stand with this parade. And I'm yes, it should have happened earlier. It's a matter of shame that
it's
happening now.
Let me get a response from him. Yeah. Professor Rao, go ahead.
It should have happened earlier.
But you didn't answer. When will you hoist the...
Yeah, what is the important thing?
1 minute. 1 minute. You had your turn, sir. Let Professor Rao have his say. Professor Rao.
No, why don't you answer first?
What is important is, you know, we need to talk about the role of universities and colleges. When the entire country... When students are protesting for constitutional values, no, I would have been happy if the Vice Chancellor decided that we will have a debate on the implementation of the Constitution. Or we will talk about the implementation of the preamble of the Indian Constitution. That would have been patriotic. When they did not have any kind of a parade for 50 years, now the context is questionable. The context is questionable. When the universities are burning, when the students are protesting all over the country, the Vice Chancellor is saying, by having, this kind of NCC parade, they're exhibiting their leadership. Universities are supposed to be developing leadership. And for the last 6 years, when has been a Vice Chancellor, he has stifled their freedom. He does not give them academic independence. He does not allow any kind of a protest. He does not allow any kind of a debate. That is what the role of the universities are. Universities are supposed to be functioning autonomously.
But Professor Rao, you would concede, sir, because you are talking about freedom in university, these students... No, no, 1 minute. Professor Rao, I agree with what you are saying. No, no, 1 minute. I don't dispute what you are saying. Professor Rao, I just want to add to something that you are saying. Because you are talking about freedom inside university campus, isn't this also an example of freedom if these girls who are part of the NCC want to do this parade on Republic Day? Why call them names?
But we are questioning the context. When
good
you
point.
Did not have it for 50 years, why you want to have this kind of a pseudo-patriotism?
But what is pseudo about this patriotism,
why did you not have
Professor
it
Rao, I don't understand
it.
Syed Asad Abbas is also saying pseudo-patriotism. What is
Professor?
Pseudo in this patriotism?
Okay. Okay,
yeah, why we
no, no, are you doubting?
No,
no, 1 minute. 1 minute. Mr. Rao, Professor Rao, are you doubting?
That's
1 minute. Are you doubting the patriotism of these girls, sir?
Because they
Or do you believe they are political pawns?
They are the Tukde gang. They want to denigrate India at the drop of the hat.
I'm not doubting the patriotism of this girl. I'm questioning the university decision. It is a university decision to have
a Republic
Day parade.
I'm doubting.
We are questioning, why are you having it when 50 years ago you did not have it?
For 50 years ago
you did not have that kind of a tradition.
And you get to know a new tradition and say that
it's a patriotic decision. They are exhibiting patriotism. They are going to be exhibiting leadership.
Is the day when the Constitution is celebrated, my dear friend. So I think when it became a republic, that is the day to be celebrated. When India became a sovereign nation.
Let them talk about the implementation of the Constitution.
Here
the university which does not allow
students to... I'm shocked that 50 years you kept quiet and did not ask for a Republic Day parade. Why did you not ask for a Republic Day parade for the last 50 years?
They don't allow enough people to come and debate. And then they're talking about this kind of a...
One minute. Professor Rao, you're talking about intellectual discussion in the university, sir. What was intellectual about the pro-Afzal slogans which were raised there?
Institution. It is running like a government department.
Professor Rao, answer the question, sir. What was intellectual about the pro-Afzal slogans?
What's the question?
Can I answer that?
And questioning the Supreme Court of this country.
There are different points of view. There are different ways of looking at it. There are different ways of looking at it. Yeah.
What about questioning democracy in the Constitution?
They were talking about Azadi from poverty, Azadi from unemployment. That is the slogan.
Professor Rao, I am not on Azadi. I am talking about the Afzal slogans. I think Mr. Abbas wants to answer that. Yes, Mr. Abbas, go ahead.
It is shocking. I have exposed you and all right. All right.
Okay, thank you. Professor Sahab, Shazia Ji, I heard the
and
two
you
of you. Allow me a minute's time, please. Thank you very much. Allow me a minute's time. I've heard you now. Kindly allow me a minute's time. Pranay Sahab, can I speak?
Yeah,
thank
you
very
go
much.
Ahead.
Firstly,
Mr. Abbas,
firstly,
Professor Rao, 1 minute, sir. Syed Abbas.
Respected sir and ma'am, I will tell you why this is. Why this is a pseudo sense of patriotism. Firstly, the RSS BJP, they will be absolute forthright sense of patriotism. When is the question? When they set a precedent themselves, when they have the national flag at their RSS headquarters, and then they do it all over Jania.
Mr. Abbas, you're not answering the question. What's intellectual about the pro-Afzal slogans? Tell me that.
But you yourself,
as always, Mr. Abbas,
what's intellectual about the Afzal slogans? You tell me that.
First, you need to
ready for public debates because you don't even know the context.
Mr. Abbas,
firstly, let me tell you.
1 minute. Shazia, help me 1 minute. 1 minute. Shazia, help me 1 minute. Let's not talk over each other. 1 minute. Shazia, 1 minute. Mr. Abbas, hear me out, sir. Hear me out. 1 minute.
Afzal slogan.
What is intellectual about the Afzal slogan? You tell me, sir.
Let me answer you. Okay, I will tell you, sir. I have had this conversation with Kanhaiya Kumar. I have had this conversation with Umar Khalid. They are my friends, and I tell you, no such slogans were raised there. Absolutely none. This is the Ranniti, this is the conspiracy of the ABVP. The Umar Khalid, Kanhaiya Kumar, I know are Deshbhakts. They are absolute patriots. RSS, BJP wants to turn them as anti-nationals because they are a voice of dissent. They want to suppress the voice of dissent. Had they said such slogans, had they been anti-national, they would have been behind the bars by now. They wouldn't have been out in the open.
No, listen, I am not here labeling people national or anti-national. 1 minute. That's not my job. 1 minute. Mr. Abbas, we are not saying that. We are not on that. 1 minute. You know, you're totally confused. I am not here doling out certificates and certifying people's patriotism. I am not calling them anti-national, national or what have you. I am only asking you if those slogans can be allowed or if other activities in the campus can be allowed. Why object to something as patriotic as this?
No such slogans were made. Yes, sir. Yeah,
but regardless, what's wrong with this?
No such slogans were made. Komal Sharma,
Mr. Abbas,
the
okay.
one who was right here is Underworld. Akshat Awasthi is out. These are RSS ABBP people.
Mr. Abbas, that
there
is for the police to look into. Mr. Abbas, that is for the police to look into. You are confusing. You are mixing two things. 1 minute. Let's leave the probe aside. Let the police do its job.
Simply not mixing. Shazia Ilmi ji spoke about the server attack. Shazia Ilmi ji spoke about Aishi Ghosh. Why can't I speak about Komal Sharma?
Yes.
Why can't
I speak about Akshay Avasthi? The professor does not have a problem with. I spoke about Afzalam Sharminda. I will speak about Tukde gang. That's what JNU is known for. Why won't I talk about JNU? Because the same professor has defended those students, and the same professor is finding those students pseudo-secular, pseudo-nationalist. So obviously I will question
because
it.
They are the goons
obviously I will question it.
All the JNU students attack, but you don't speak about it. How can
but you don't have a point to make on
very,
this.
Very convenient.
But you don't have a point to make on NCC and the Republic Day parade. Because you've caught bluffing and exposed and you're all over the place and you look very, very silly saying this. So you just parrot the same old lines, not making any sense whatsoever and contributing nothing to what could have been a good debate.
To give us out certificates
keep
of nationalism.
Keep talking, keep yapping, Sayed Abbas, without making any sense. Keep yapping. Yap more.
Nagpur,
be my guest.
Prove their nationalism.
Okay.
Be kind to yourself and stop yapping because you're not making any sense.
Let's not get personal here. 1 minute. Sayed Abbas, Shazia Ilmi, calm down.
No, he's going on talking and you're not even. I'm very calm. I'm very amused because I'm making the point on NCC. And I'm saying that the same professor was talking about freedom of expression of those students. And the same professor is not talking about the NCC. And he's talking about the cadets' right to express commitment on Republic Day. So they are just rabble rousers. And they will not support anything that is to protect the sovereignty
okay,
of
let
our
me,
country,
let me
to
get
show
Professor
commitment
Rao
to our
answer
country
why
on Republic Day parade. So
there?
They have a problem
that
with that.
Okay, Shazia, you asked the question.
Abbas, I don't want to argue with. I want to argue with the professor.
Okay. Why professor, Shazia Ilmi is asking you a question. Would you want to answer that, sir?
Yeah, please, I will definitely answer. But first you must know how universities and colleges are supposed to function.
This is not how colleges are supposed to function.
Hello.
Nowhere in the world do students dictate that the fees should be not increased from 10 rupees and 20 rupees per day. I don't think this happens anywhere else in the world or any other city.
Yeah,
and
but that
especially
has to be negotiated. That has to be discussed with
this
them.
This does not allow
that
for students to run amok. So please. So yeah, it has been discussed with them many times and we all know that. So please, that has been discussed many, many times. No, it doesn't have to be discussed with them and they can't hold any university to ransom. They could not hold anybody university to ransom, that's one. But if some students want to march, why should you call them pseudo-nationalist?
Call the students.
Why don't you have pseudo-secular? No, why should they be pseudo-nationalist? Tell me. Why are you being? Why are you calling them pseudo nationalists? Because they want to show their commitment and they want NCC cadets.
Professor Rao, we don't have much time on the show, sir. Go first.
No, I don't think Sayed Abbas has much to say. But I think let the professor speak because Sayed Abbas.
Show commitment to secular values.
Is it in Constitution? Read the Central Universities Act. Read, have you know about University Grants Commission? Do you even know how Central Universities run?
The context is questionable.
Is this?
The context is questionable.
But talking about Afzal Guru, because Supreme Court.
How is the context questionable? I can't understand that. No, I don't understand that. Unfortunately, we've run out of time. We've run out of time. Shazia Ilmi, Professor Rao, Sayed Abbas, we've unfortunately completely out of time. Let's leave it at that. JNU India Parade is our hashtag. Viewers can use that to engage with us. I thank all of you for joining me on Newsnight on Times Now World.